Hello and welcome back to another All About Apps by the Cleveroad Studio. Let's find out what's new for today. I suppose smartwatches and other wearable devices come as no surprise to anyone these days. As devices get smaller and more powerful, they find their way into our everyday objects. We don't only carry personal computers in our pockets, but we also wear them. Wearables come in various shapes, sizes, and degrees of sophistication. The marketplace for smartwatches is blossoming. Therefore, more and more smart app watch developers are trying to figure out how to make their software stand out from the competition. While functionality and innovation have always been obvious moves, there are a few key features to be considered while building apps for wearable devices. If you want to create a smartwatch application or a smartwatch extension for your mobile app, you should first consider and understand the basics of user interaction with these unusually sized devices. Fortunately, Apple and Google have provided developers with detailed guidelines and best practices on how to create smartwatch apps which users won't reject after first contact. So, let's take a brief look at those standards. The Android concept of input and output data is based on voice control and context awareness. The Android Wear UI is based around the two primary functions of suggest and demand. The suggest function is actually the context stream, a series of cards displaying suitable and timely pieces of information. Such UI models don't require the launch of an app to check for updates. A simple glance at the stream provides a brief update. The demand part of the UI model is just an application launcher that responds to the user's queries. It doesn't require the developer to predict the user's possible needs during development. When developing Android Wear apps, try to follow these design principles to provide users with a great user experience. Number one, the app should be as focused as possible. If it takes more than 5 seconds, the user stops using it, which conflicts with the basics of smartwatch development. Number two, the area for interaction is limited, so consider how big your gestures can be to ensure the best app interaction, even when walking. Number three, stream cards are of great importance. Make a list of common situations and provide the right content as and when the user needs it. Number four, one piece at a time. Split the bits of information into separate cards and use multiple pages. That is the key to success. Now it's Apple's turn. Apple Watch apps are an extension of the iPhone apps using the WatchKit SDK. The interaction methods provided by Apple include gestures, force touch, digital crown, and side button. When it comes to the way users interact with Apple Watch apps, there are four major principles that are worthy of your attention. First, notifications. Do not underestimate the value of notifications in Apple Watch apps. It is the way of quick interaction. Glances. These provide users with only the most useful info that appears at the right moment and place. The detailed information shown in glances or notifications is provided in watch apps. Complications allows timely and relevant information about your app on the watch face. Basically, the biggest difference between the two platforms is architecture. Android Wear is a fully operational operating system, while you can't use an Apple Watch without an iPhone. Finally, I've got a few general tips that will ensure the best usability and performance of your smartwatch app on any platform. Be efficient. Make sure your app is touch and glance friendly. Wearers don't want to be having to sit and struggle with your app's functionality. Be reasonable. Although this device has direct access to body parameters and sight, which opens up new horizons for creativity, it's not a good idea to overload your app. Be thoughtful. Keep fonts readable and the overall design discreet. Also, don't forget about testing this aspect of your design before release. Be economical. Keep in mind things like battery consumption and processing power. Be compatible. Smartwatches at most are paired with smartphones, so let your customers enjoy the benefits of smartphone functionality in your watch app. Creating smartwatch apps is slightly more user-orientated than those used on smartphones. The design approach shouldn't follow the paradigm of making smartphone features fit the watch. It's better to figure out what needs to be done to get the most out of the watch and make it even better than the smartphone. Well, people, it seems that this episode has come to an end. To read the full article, visit our blog page. In order not to miss the next video in our series All About Apps, subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Bye for now.